Hi crafters, Amy here, and today I'm going to make some embossed thank you cards that I'm going to give away as gift sets. So I'm going to jump right in and show you some of the products. I have this stamp and cut set from Hero Arts. It's really cool. It comes with two really nice dies and all those sentiment stamps that go along with it, but I'm just using that thanks die that comes with it today. And you can see I'm just using my Spellbinders Platinum 6 die cutting machine. I'm just going to cut out a bunch of these thanks in gold and then also in some holographic cardstock that I have. And basically, these cards are so simple, guys. I can't even tell you, but the wow factor is there. It's these embossing folders from Altenew. They're just incredible. I just added a couple more into my crafty stash, and I will link all of them in the video description box below. But they are incredible. They're 3D, and they give you that wow factor on your cards without the effort. So you can see here, I just have seriously like a cheap, lightweight colored cardstock. This is a really good way to use it up, and I'm just spritzing it lightly with some water. I don't think you have to go this step, but I do think it does give it a little bit more definition, and it kind of will prevent you from cracking your cardstock if you're gonna use a thicker one. So I'm just looking at my platform here. Whatever, you know, embossing or die cutting machine you have, just look at whatever your recommended sandwich is. This I'm kind of on the fence because it's technically a 3D, but I know it works with just the regular top plate. So I'm just going to run it through a few times and then you will see the magic. These Altenew embossing folders are just amazing. Look at that. That is crazy town to me. So I'm going to go a step further. I have some Hero Hues. This is the Unicorn, I believe, pigment ink, and I'm just brushing it on here. I'm super light-handed, which it's not easy for me to do because I'm normally coming at stuff like a lumberjack, but I'm just very lightly brushing this across the top of those raised areas. And you'll see there are a couple areas where I kind of, you know, get it on the part that I don't want it. So if that bothers you, maybe you could use a blending tool or just maybe not be impatient like me. But another option here is to add some splatter. So I just kind of smush some of that pigment right on a block, and I have a water brush pen from Arteza, and I'm just using that to kind of add some splatter. Now, I don't actually use this panel in the cards. I did a lot of them off camera for, you know, the sake of brevity, but I just wanted to show you that's how I got the splatters that you'll see in these cards that I've already made. So I have them already attached to A2 size card bases, so 4.25 by 5.5, and then I've done different things. So like I rounded the edges on that navy one, I kind of cut it down a little bit for a white border on the green, I rounded all the edges on the orange one. So I've basically got 4 of each of these. I just cut up, you know, a regular 8.5 by 11 piece of cheapy colored cardstock, so I got 4 of every color, and I'm going to get 4 gift sets out of this when all said and done. So I just ran them all through the embossing folders like you saw, brushed over the top with the white pigment, and now I'm just kind of figuring out which 2 are going to get the holographic and which 2 are going to get the gold. And I opted to use liquid glue here just because there is so much, you know, dimension in terms of raised areas and recessed areas on this paper. You probably could run it through with like an adhesive backed kind of sheet or something like that and basically make them stickers. Those would probably work too, but I just thought I would use my liquid glue here and basically just get it lined up and attach it down. You see I did blot off that excess glue on that piece of scrap paper. Now here I'm showing you my sentiment book. I did have some extra thank yous that I didn't end up using, so I was able to load them up into my batching beauty folder here. So I've got these extra thanks I'm just going to put in. These are little baseball card pockets, so I just get them from Amazon. I'll link that down below the video as well too if you're interested in getting that. But I have this book for my sentiments, and I also have one for my stamped and colored critters, so I have them all ready to go. So you can see here I have 4 of every single one of these designs, so that's 4 card sets, one of each design, or you could, you know, double it up and give them 2 of each design. I kind of had my daughter's teachers in mind for this. I figure they always need thank you cards. And I like to give them something handmade for Christmas. I know they get inundated with things like that, but I always give them gift cards and things like that too. But I like to give them something handmade from the heart. So I'm just basically going to take one of each kind and 4 envelopes. And I have these little plastic pouches also that I got off Amazon. And I kind of load them up and I end up having 4 different sets. Now, if these were any thicker or had any other dimension, I don't think they would fit in this bag. I mean, they were at their limit. It worked fine. I got them in, but I was pushing it, folks. I was pushing it. So these should work, assuming you don't go too thick. But if you're, you know, doubling up on dimension and things like that, then you might not be able to get as many in these bags. So here we go. I got 4 gift sets. I was thinking these would be so pretty with like a ribbon tied around them or some twine or something like that. So I hope this gives you guys some ideas. These embossing folders are amazing. And I just think it's so extra with that little bit of white pigment on it. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please hit the thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. All the details below will give you the information on the products that I used. And I'll catch you next time. Thank you. Bye.